How do you think dinosaur bones get to museums? The answer? Hard work.
Hi, my name is Doug Goodreau, and I'm the lab manager for the Dinosaur Institute at the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles County.
Doug and a large team of experts and scientists find fossils, take them out of the ground, transport them back to the museum, clean and prepare the fossils, assemble them, and finally put the bones on display at the museum. The process can take years and years, and is very hard and dirty work.
And field work, I find, is the most satisfying and exciting part of paleontology, because you're actually physically there digging up the specimen. And even though something might not be a new discovery, per se, it's the first time you've dug something up.
Currently, the Dino Institute is working to extract a new sauropod species in Utah they've named Gnatalie. Sauropods are huge, long-necked dinosaurs, and Gnatalie might be a brand new species.
Gnatalie is a new sauropod, and we know that because there's some interesting features to it. We haven't found the skull yet. The skull and teeth are usually very diagnostic or give you a better idea of what animal exactly this is. But we're comparing it to a lot of other animals that have been found similar to it.
So if preparing fossils is such a long process, how do you get started? First, you have to find the fossils, and to do that, you have to think like a paleontologist.
So we look for strange rocks and fragments, and maybe those are connected to other things, or maybe it's just a wash from an old river channel, or some things eroding out of a hill. We follow that up and see where the source is of those fragments, and then dig in.
After they find the fossils, then the fun really begins. This process is messy, hard, and takes a lot of time and people.
First, we'll expose as much as we can and then cap it, and that's putting plaster and burlap layers of that on top of the specimen. And then we might have to splint it with possibly some 2x4s or rebar or pipe or other materials to then stabilize this, much like you would if you had a broken arm. You'd want to put a cast on it, and so we call it jacketing. And we'll get that jacket on the top of the specimen, trench around it, and then get a jacket around the sides of it, then tunnel underneath it.
The process of jacketing helps move the fossils safely, but the team has to be careful because now all the fossils, rock, and plaster can weigh more than a ton.
By the time we have this block of material with lots of fossils out of the ground, then comes the challenge of logistics, and that is getting this nice package back to the museum.
Once the fossils are back at the museum, then the team can really start to discover what they found, and sometimes they're really surprised.
So we'll try to open it as carefully as we can, often discovering new elements that we might have included in the jacket we weren't even aware of, because we have to trench around the specimen enough to where we want to lighten the load and knock off the rock and debris and dirt as much as we can. But in between the bones, we'll find additional bones, sometimes teeth from another animal, for example. That'll give us a better insight to the paleoenvironment it came from.
But wait! They're not ready to put the fossils together yet. Now, they need to pull away all the extra dirt and rock. This is called matrix. To do this, they use dental picks and special tools called zip scribes. Once the fossils are clean, that's when they can finally start assembling the dinosaurs, just like a puzzle. Doug and the Dino Institute spend a lot of time looking at how fossils fit together and why. The result is great. Full dinosaur skeletons that help us imagine what it was like millions and millions of years ago.
Paleontology is a big puzzle. It's a paleo crime scene, if you will, that we're looking at and trying to figure out by cleaning things up, drawing it out, cleaning that up on the computer, and then kind of looking at the overall plan and seeing what we've got.
Do you want to think like a paleontologist? Solve your own dino puzzle at the Curiosity Machine.